Hello everyone, this is Akin Magnetho. You know, now here is a quick one. Now in my previous videos, I promised that you whenever you comment on my videos, I'm gonna make sure I do the tutorial you asked me to do. Right now I'm trying to, a client of mine post a question to me, or let me say she posted a request that she wants to design a mini page that has a login register and where she can track the people that registered. She can manage requests and she can manage complaints. Now, for sake of everyone, I'm doing this as a tutorial so as to make you, you know, also good. Now, I'm going to use Bootstrap and I'm going to use PHP MySQL. So, let's get it. Now, this is a very quick preview of what we're about to do, or this is a quick preview of what you achieve at the end. Now, we have the header here. User page, which is just an example, so you can change it to yours. I will show you how to change it. Now we have the header here, register. You can see we have a nice button here. You can see we have all this. We have a nice footer, a static one which doesn't move. Now I'll teach you how to do that as well. Now we have the login, the login which shows this, so you can enter anything here. Now I'm going to walk you through how to handle all these things, don't worry. So it's promised to be interesting. Now for the members area, that means when they log in. Now mind you, these pages are first designed in HTML, so later we change them to PHP, because it is when you want to add interactivity, that is when PHP comes in. Now for the members area, assuming the user has registered, so I've successfully logged in, it will take the user to this page, which is the members area. So I don't want to take much of your time, so I decided just to make it a very quick one. So if you click this button, you see, click it's a modal form. That is the name it's called in Bootstrap. It's called a modal form. Now send request click, that means you are not moving out of a page, and send complaints. This is just one of the techniques I taught which is going to help out. So, and we have your logouts button here. They go back home. Now quickly, let me take you through the folder structure of the website. Now the folder structure of this design project is that we have several pages here which will be designed on the user side, and we have some that manage on the admin side. Now going back to the user side, we have index, register, login, members, send request, complaint, logout, and connection. Now I'll tell you how all these are, and I will show you how to design it, everything. So keep tabs on this page. You can subscribe to receive more, or you know, you can submit your comments whenever you are not clear. And this on the admin side, we are going to create the index, login, admin area, manage user. That means where you manage, just put a register on your website so that you can, you know, send emails to them in the future. Or and also we have a page here where you can manage your complaints. That means whenever a client sends you a complaint, there is a way you can manage it as well inside your folder on your database without using email address. Now this is the logout, which is very common. Now this is how the database is going to be. Now before anything can be fetched, or before anything can be saved inside the database, it needs a connection file, and the name of the connection file is called connection.php. don't worry, I'll take you through it. Now we have the admin folder. That means before this access the MySQL, it has to pass through the connection. That means to check if the connection, as in to create a connection and to check if the connection still exists. That is when it can successfully get access inside your database and stuff like that. Now we have, that means we are going to make use of we are going to keep track of three things: we manage users, manage complaints, and manage requests. That means on the admin dashboard. Now how to set up the variables is very simple. We download Bootstrap, we download jQuery, we extract them, we open our text folder, our text editor, sorry, and we link the Bootstrap file and we continue coding. Now let's get straight to this. Let me launch my Google Chrome. Let's get started. Now, get Bootstrap.